fire. An element bearing direct to the soul or like to the gods. From humankind's earliest memories, fire has presented a dual character. It burned his home or cooked his food. To the witches of Salem and the Jews of Dachau, it meant horror. To the Vikings of Shetland, for Hindus of the Ganges, it brought honor and remembrance. As early as perhaps 100,000 years ago, humans puzzled over what to do with their dead. Leave them to the animals of the forest, or honor them with ground burial, or to burn the bodies, cremation. To fully understand the origins of cremation, we must travel backwards through time. 20,000 BC. The Mongol lady, her partially cremated body was found in 1969 by an archaeological expedition, the earliest evidence of cremation yet found. Over the next 10,000 years, Native American archaeological digs have uncovered instances of cremation in Alaska and California. As a form of ancestor worship and associated with the rise of Buddhism, cremated remains were discovered in ancient earthenware pots in China. Around 1900 BC in the northern part of India, cremated remains were placed in painted pottery burial urns. Evidence of cremation memorialization was found in Greece as early as 1000 BC. By 700 BC, cremation was recognized as the dominant form of disposition in Greece. From circa 500 BC to the decline of Rome in around 300 AD, cremation was a common practice in Rome. The Romans constructed the first columbariums, store the urns containing cremated remains of family and loved ones. Around 313 AD, the Roman Emperor Constantine adopted Christianity as Rome's official religion. Christian tradition demanded that the body be kept intact following death. This preserves the body whole for the promised resurrection. Consequently, cremation was banned by Constantine by 330 AD. In the Viking world, the bodies of the highborn and heroes were cast adrift and set afire in Viking boats. In 522 AD, Buddhism and cremation came to Japan, and Emperor Jito was the first Japanese leader to be cremated in 733. However, to Christianity in Rome, these were pagan practices. To Christians of the Middle Ages, the burning of dead bodies amounted to desecration. Cremation was strictly outlawed and punishable by death. Burning was confined to heretics, non-believers, and martyrs. In the Middle Ages, cremation served a different purpose. The bodies of slain enemies and heretics were burned and desecrated. They could not return to life during the resurrection. But burning was sometimes employed out of necessity to hinder the spread of disease, notably during the years of the Black Plague. In 1869, the idea of cremation as a form of disposition re-entered the Western world in the presentation of the Medical International Congress of Florence by Professors Coletti, Castiglione, in the name of public health and civilization. Professor Ludovico Brunetti of Padua published reports and experiments he had conducted and displayed his model of a crematorium at the 1873 Vienna Exposition. This display captured the imagination of Queen Victoria's personal physician, Sir Henry Thompson, who championed the modern cremation. The first crematorium in North America built in Washington, Pennsylvania in 1876. The crematorium was built by Dr. Julius Lamour. You will now travel back in time to 1876, entering through a replica of Dr. Lemoyne's crematory to see artifacts and displays from early cremation in American history to modern-day processes of memorialization.